हाय नैना, राइट, ओके।
सो नाउ वी लर्न अबाउट अ लेविस ऑक्टेट रूल एंड लेविस सिंबल्स। व्हाट इज लेविस ऑक्टेट रूल? ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट लेविस ऑक्टेट रूल इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास। सो इट इज नथिंग बट इट्स अ टेंडेंसी ऑफ एटम्स टू अचीव टेंडेंसी ऑफ एटम्स to achieve 8 electrons in their outermost shell. So with that tendency, what the atoms will do? So generally Lewis octet rule means tendency of atoms or else behavior of atoms to achieve 8 electrons in their outermost shell. So in order to achieve 8 electrons in their outermost shell, they will undergo chemical reaction, they will participate in chemical reactions. See, actually Lewis octet rule, it is the basis for electron theory of valence. See, actually chemical bond, the formation of chemical bond can be explained by many theories. One of the theory is electron theory of valence. So we'll discuss about this theory later. Okay, so for time being, just we should know that Lewis octet rule, it forms the basis for electron theory of valence. Next, what are Lewis symbols? Lewis symbols are also called as electron dot symbols. See, generally a symbol, generally atoms possess symbols. Not only symbols, they also possess Lewis symbols. We can write Lewis symbols for every atom. So how? So for to write the Lewis symbols, we have to take the help of symbol of the element and the valence electrons of that element. For example, take a carbon or else take hydrogen. So in hydrogen atom there are only one valence electron. Carbon, so there are four valence electrons. Nitrogen, there are five valence electrons. If you write the electronic configuration of nitrogen, if you write, so it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So how many so this is the first orbit and this is the last orbit. Last orbit is called as valency shell or else valency orbit, and the electrons present in it are said to be valency electrons. So how many valency electrons are there in nitrogen? So there are 5 valency electrons. Out of 5 valency electrons, if you closely observe, so these 5 valency electrons are present in s orbitals and p orbitals. So in s orbital there are 2 electrons a pair, and in p orbital there are 3 single electrons. So like this, a pair and 3 single electrons are present in the valency shell. So that is why nitrogen here, if you want to write a Lewis symbol for nitrogen, so the first we have to write the symbol of the element N and the valence electrons. So how many valence electrons are there? 5 valence electrons are there. So that means 2 electrons are paired here. These 2 electrons are paired and 3 electrons are unpaired. So like this we can write the Lewis symbol. Lewis symbol, here in Lewis symbols, valence electrons are represented by dots or cross. So here I used crosses to represent the Lewis symbols. Here in this case I used dots. See, chlorine atom, its configuration is what? So chlorine's configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. So this is the valence shell. This is the valence shell, and there are 7 valence electrons. So these 7 valence electrons are represented like this. So in s there are in s orbitals a pair, and in p orbitals two more pairs and one unpaired electron. So here altogether there are 3 pairs of electrons and one unpaired electron. So like this we can write the Lewis symbols of different elements. So for hydrogen, Lewis symbol is like this. Carbon, like this. Nitrogen, neon, like this. See, in general, so we can write a Lewis symbol for every group. For example, if Lewis symbol for first A group, generally if this is the element belong to first A group, then one electron. one electron, one this first A group element possesses only one valence electron. So this is the general symbol for general Lewy symbol for first A group, and this is the general Lewy symbol for second A group, general Lewy symbol for third A group, general Lewy symbol for fourth A group. See, look here, up to four groups there are only unpaired electrons, so there is no pairing up to fourth A group, and from here onwards, so we have to write the pairs. So when fifth electron is added, so the fifth electron will pair up, so the sixth electron will pair up here, okay, like this. So there are two pairs, and when seventh electron will pair another, so it will cause three pairs and one unpaired. So eighth electron, so like this, when eight electrons are there in the valence shell, so it forms four pairs of electrons. So like this, Lewy symbol of each and every group can be written like this. See, seventh A group, so chlorine, seventh A group, chlorine belongs to seventh A group. So general symbol for seventh A group is like this, general Lewy symbol. So specifically, if you take a chlorine, so chlorine is one of the example for seventh A group. So it is represented like this. So fourth A group, if you take, so like this, fourth A carbon. So carbon, the Lewy symbol of carbon can be written like this. Fifth A group, from fifth A group, nitrogen can be specified as example. So like this, Lewy symbols we can write. Okay, next, if you see the valences, so unpaired electrons, valence is nothing but unpaired electrons. Only unpaired electrons will participate in bonding. So only one unpaired electrons will participate in bonding. So if there are the number of bonds that an atom forms will depend upon the unpaired electrons. So here, first A group will form only one bond because one unpaired electron is present. Hence, their valence is one. So valency means number of bonds. Already we have seen in our previous classes that valency is nothing but number of bonds formed by an element. So it depends upon the number of unpaired electrons. So first A group contains only one unpaired electron, hence its valency is one. Second A group contains two unpaired electrons, its valency is two. Third A group contains three valence electrons, three unpaired valence electrons, hence its valency is three valency. So here fourth A group, four unpaired electrons, valency is four. In fifth A group, only three valence electrons, three unpaired electrons and one pair. So we have to consider only unpaired electrons for valences. So as there are only three unpaired electrons, so the valence of fifth A group is three only. And for sixth A group, only two unpaired electrons, hence its valence is two. And seventh A group, only one unpaired electron in the valence shell, hence its valence is one. So valence is nothing but number of unpaired electrons present in the outermost orbit will give the valency. So for representative elements, generally these are representative elements. So these are the groups related to S and P block, that means representative elements groups. Okay, so like this we can learn the Lewy's octet tool and Lewy's symbol. Next, we will learn some other concepts like explanation of chemical bond. How chemical bonds are formed between the atom. So this was not known to the scientists in the earlier days, how the bond is formed between the atoms, chemical bond is formed between the atoms, that means how the atoms combine. So this was not known. So at the early stages, these scientists, they tried to explain how the chemical bonds are formed between the atoms. Okay, so out of so many scientists at the time after the discovery of electrons, that means electrons are present in the atom. So after the fact after the fact that electrons are present in the atom, electrons are present in the atom. So the focus after the fact that the electrons are present in the atom, then the scientists, the focus on the formation of chemical bond was given to electrons. So based on the electrons, scientists, they try to explain about the formation of chemical bond. So out of so many different experiments and theories proposed by several scientists, the best theory, the earlier known best theory was electron theory of valence. Electron theory of valence. So this is the first accepted theory about the chemical bonding. So these are the theories of chemical bondings. There are so many theories of chemical bonding. So we will learn the theories of chemical bonding one by one. So this is the first theory. Okay, electron theory of valency. It is also called as Ocell and Lewis theory. The next theory is valency bond theory. Okay. Next to valency bond theory, see, actually this electron theory of valency was given by Ocell and Lewis. Okay, next to this Ocell and Lewis theory, so it is valency bond theory. So the valency bond theory, it was given by scientist known as Pauling. See, actually this valency bond theory was given by Hitler and London, but later on it was improved by Pauling and Slater. So these scientists, they have developed this theory. Valency bond theory was developed by Pauling and Slater. So that means these two scientists, they extended this theory. The theory proposed by Hitler and London was extended by Pauling and Slater to many compounds. So the next theory is hybridization theory. So this is also proposed by Pauling. Next to hybridization theory is Vesper theory. Valency shell electron pair repulsion theory. So we will learn about this one, Vesper theory. So we will learn all these theories one by one. So it is given by Gillespie and Nyholm. Okay, so next to Vesper theory. So the next theory is molecular orbital theory. So these are the theories which explain about the formation of chemical bond. Hence these theories are said to be theories of chemical bond. So all these theories will explain how chemical bond is formed. here initial theory, the first theory proposed is electron theory of valency. So these theory have some defects. In order to remove the defects, a new theory called as valency bond theory was proposed, and this theory also is having some defects. So the defects can be eliminated. To eliminate the defects, a new theory was proposed by scientists, hybridization theory, and this is another theory, Wesper theory, okay, and molecular orbital theory. The most advanced theory is molecular orbital theory. So we learn all these theories one by one. First we learn about the electron theory of valence. Electron theory of valency, Gödel and Lewis. According to this theory, so valence electrons are responsible. Valence electrons are responsible for the formation of chemical bonds. Valency electrons are responsible for the formation of chemical bonds. See, this theory has proposed certain points. So let us learn the important points about theory. Important points of electron theory of valence. Important points of electron theory of valence. So first point. What is this first point? First point says that valency of an atom depends on the number of electrons present in the outermost orbit.